next to her, the swimming pool. Somebody dives in, and she's not too pretty. So I can think of something else. I think of the waves that are formed in the water, and I think that it's possible, maybe, that in those waves is a clue as to what's happening in the pool. That some sort of insect or some sort of efficient cleverness could sit in the corner of the pool and just be disturbed by the wave. And by the nature of the irregularities and bumping of the wave, have figured out who jumped in, where and when, and where what's happening all over the pool. And that's what we're doing when we're looking at something. The light that comes out of it is waves, just like in a swimming pool, except in three dimensions instead of the two dimensions of the pool that's going in all directions. And we have an eighth of an inch black hole in which these things go. And we want to get more information when we swivel this ball around sort of the hole. But so that in this space, not only my vision of you, but information from Moscow radio that's being broadcast at the present moment, and the seeing of somebody from Peru, plus the X-rays, cosmic rays, all these other things, the same kind of waves, exactly the same waves, but that all these things are going through the room at the same time, which everybody knows, but you've got to stop and think about it to really get the pleasure about the complexity, the inconceivable nature of nature.